I'm Salome Muligeta with Tadias Magazine. I'm here at Spur Tree to talk to Sean John, a great friend of mine. He's going to tell us the love that he has for Ethiopia and his restaurant. Come on, check it out with me. Hello. Hi, Sean.
Hey, Salome. How are you doing? Oh, welcome. Ethiopian style.
Sean John is the owner of Spur Tree Restaurant in the Lower East Side of Manhattan in New York. Originally from Kingston, Jamaica, moved to New York to pursue film and photography, which he did, then fell into culinary. Spur Tree is a contemporary Jamaican-Asian cuisine with emphasis on local ingredients, and it draws from the multi-ethnic nature of its surroundings. Sean has been getting great reviews from all over the world. Recently was featured on an award-winning popular television show in Denmark, on the front pages of Jamaican newspaper, and Macy's just picked him as one of the top 10 restaurants to go and eat in Manhattan.
Hi, Sean. Good to see you.
Hey, good to see you.
Thank you. Thank you. What a beautiful place you have. How long have you been open?
I've been open for 3 years.
And I hear you're doing fabulous.
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good. A lot of hard work. It's paying off. Business is pretty steady. Yeah, I have to give thanks to Jah for that.
The word around the corner is that you love Ethiopia so much. What is that about? When were you first introduced to Ethiopia?
Ethiopia, whoa. That's a long, we could go on forever talking about Ethiopia, but just to be short, my mom was Rastafarian when I was a kid. So they always talk about Ethiopia. Like everyone talk about Selassie, everyone talk about returning to Africa, specifically Ethiopia. And we kind of always have an Ethiopian consciousness in Jamaica for some interesting reason. And then they have the Ethiopian Orthodox churches in Jamaica. And it's just a strong affinity for Ethiopia, which I think really started with Marcus Garvey. He's the one that said, like, look at Ethiopia, yeah, which is more Selassie. That's the real connection, and then Ethiopia itself.
Sean is known by his friends as Globerati since he has traveled throughout the world. But one of his favorite places to go to is Ethiopia.
I know some people have an intimate or soul connection with a certain person or a certain country. So do you feel that you're specifically connected with Ethiopia?
Yeah, the funny thing is I've been to like 10 African countries, and in Ethiopia, it was one of the best experiences I had in Africa. The thing is, people are always saying I kind of look like an Ethiopian person, so that made it a little bit easier. I was shooting there, people just very, very warm, always sweet. Oh, it was really good experience. I feel like many people are brothers and sisters. It was very, very, very cool.
So when you went to Ethiopia, you took a lot of pictures, and I know that you were there for a while. I don't know how long you were there for.
I was in Ethiopia 2005. For like about a month.
Okay.
I went to Ethiopia because I got a job with UNICEF and Bob Marley Foundation.
Okay.
So I was shooting for a week on a project, and then afterwards I just went traveling on my own.
He has traveled to Ethiopia, taking pictures, understanding the culture, the hospitality, the people, and the local restaurants from Oromo region, which is the southern part of Ethiopia, through Addis Ababa, the capital city of Ethiopia.
Which was amazing. I went all the way south, near Kenya, the Omoro area, and Awassa, and Abaminch, and like really far in. Because I really wanted to know the country and understand it, I went north to like Lalibela and other Christian churches and stuff like that, the Orthodox churches.
The logo for the restaurant is in a way a dedication for the love he has for the country. To combine both Jamaica and Ethiopia together, Sean used for his logo a name of a hill in Jamaica called Spur Tree and a beautiful picture of a tree he took in Ethiopia.
And what is this picture that I see behind us? Is this in Ethiopia?
Oh, that's actually our logo. For the restaurant, which is an interesting story.
Okay.
And yeah, it is in Ethiopia.
What's the story behind it?
Well, the story behind that, the tree was, I was driving going south, and I just saw this beautiful tree with this house, a small house underneath the tree, and then this guy. So I told the guy, hey, pull the car over, let me take a picture of this guy's house. So I went to the guy that is a little farmer, and I'm like, man, I love your house, can I take a picture? And he was so humble. He's like, oh, my house is not so beautiful. Go down the road, they have bigger houses. But I'm like, no, the tree and the house and the guy outside was just perfect. So I took it and I really liked it. When I came back to New York like 2 years later, Common Center is opening this restaurant. And I wanted a photograph.
Oh, okay.
So And the name of the place is Spur Tree, which is a town in Jamaica. But I didn't have a nice tree from anywhere else. The nicest tree was that tree from Ethiopia. So I just used the tree and the name from Jamaica.
Okay.
Plus, we're all originally, our roots is in Africa on a deeper level. We all have African roots, so the tree represents our roots in motherland Africa.
Wow.
So that's the real reason, actually. Yeah, a lot of people always think I'm Ethiopian. Yeah, so, and I think it's a compliment. I think Ethiopian people are super beautiful. I mean, both physically and artistically, so that's always nice. And the woman in Ethiopia is just like, wow. So are you, by the way.
One can describe Spur Tree's cuisine as trendy, cool, joyful, and yet deeply rooted in traditional Jamaican cuisine.
The cuisine is actually Jamaican Asian.
Okay.
So we do traditional Jamaican dishes like oxtail, jerk chicken, curry goat, ackee and saltfish, and we also do Asian stuff,
okay.
Which is like we do shrimp tempura, shumai, dumplings, vegetable dumplings, bok choy, that kind of thing.
And do a lot of people from Ethiopia come?
Yeah, we have a lot of Ethiopian customers. Well, they come and always feel at home, you know, and they like reggae and they like Bob Marley, so it's always
a nice
place.
So you have music here that you play?
Yeah, we have music with a DJ that spins,
okay,
on most nights. And it's always like a dinner lounge atmosphere and gets very packed and very nice, good energy.
Jamaica has a very strong connection with Ethiopia, so I play a little bit of Ethiopian music along with reggae and mix it up a little bit.
You're very well known, so they're lucky to have you here.
It's my roots. I love being here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I was also going to ask you, do a lot of Ethiopians follow you, come to hear music?
Friends from different walks of life. Yeah, some who come and see me here, some who come and see me at my other places, but yes, I do.
Yeah? And I want to ask you, is this something that maybe you want to expand, get big in DJing, or do you do dancing and things like that?
Yeah, I'm also a dancer. I'm a professional dancer. I mean, I love DJing. I love anything to do with music, so I would, I mean, as far as DJing, I think I'm doing what I want to do. Like, I love playing in places like these. I like doing big events. I like doing fashion shows. I do movie releases, book releases, fashion shows, little intimate lounges and clubs. So as a DJ, I'm pretty happy with what I'm doing. And as I said, I also dance professionally with my own collective that I put together. Right now I'm playing at this other little lounge called La Esquina,
okay,
on Tuesdays, and then this new restaurant that just opened, Miss Lily's, on Wednesday.
Okay, so we can kind of take our Ethiopian crowd to where you are.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Always.
Nice
always.
To see you. Yeah, actually I was reading that you were, I think, one of the top 10 restaurants in the Lower East Side that Macy's had picked, is that right?
Yeah, it was a big compliment for Macy's. Have a culinary institute,
okay,
and they choose the 10 hottest chefs in the city,
okay,
every year. I think in the country, actually.
Oh wow!
But more, and they chose Spur Tree and they chose me to do a demonstration in the cellar. That was February for Black History Month.
Okay. And then you recently had a story on Jamaican newspaper, is that correct?
Yeah, there's something on Jamaican paper about just as a Jamaican person making moves in New York or doing well in New York.
And then you took some pictures. You're also a photographer, so you took your cinematography.
Yeah, I'll show you some stuff.
Sean is an all-around Renaissance man, a business owner, a very talented photographer, a cinematographer. He has worked on many different movies and documentaries behind the scenes, such as The Waitress, Mo, the celebration of Bob Marley's 60th birthday, which was actually shot in Ethiopia. Sean John is now very much in demand, and he continues to draw rave reviews, and he'll be serving his food at Whole Foods in the near future.
So what nights are good nights to come?
Oh, like a Friday is good. Saturday is really good. The weekends are good. Sundays, every night is a good night.
Yeah.
I want to just tell you, this area is so nice. I really like it.
Yeah, this, you're in the Lower East Side. We're borderline Chinatown. It's very up and coming, very trendy. It's a good place to be. They have lots of different restaurants. So you have us, you have Austrian, you have Thai, Vietnamese, lots of good boutiques and stuff like that.
Very hip.
Yeah, very hip. This is the new, it's getting drenched. Before it was a Jewish, it was an immigrant neighborhood with all the tenements. But now it's changing and becoming
very hip
and gentrified. So,
and you're open throughout the week?
We close on Mondays, okay. But we open from Tuesday to Sunday.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming by, man. I really appreciate it. I'm gonna get back to work.
Okay.
Come
nice
by later.
Okay,
definitely come party with us later.
Okay,
all right, ciao.
Sean, bye.
I have a feeling this is only the beginning. Stay tuned.